Good humans, you have asked for it. It's here. It's Chain Reaction Tuesdays with yours truly, Al Too Smooth, the mountain biker. Today, we're going to take out a couple of bikes. I'm going to try my best not to break my neck on a BMX bike that some of you have been asking me about. And my coworker over there with pink hair, whom I won't say out loud, Jill, we're going to try these BMX bikes out and hopefully we don't break our neck. But there was another bike that you guys had emailed me and asked me about specifically. And yes, I am doing a review. You guys asked about it. It's here. Chain Reaction Tuesdays. Come on, let's get to it. Good humans. So today's test and review, we're gonna take this bike out in mainstream traffic and I want to see her capabilities. As a commuter bike, this bike has the capability of keeping up with traffic. Now, the reason why I said I'm gonna take her out in mainstream traffic is because I put her in turbo and as you can see, we are zipping. Now, I don't advise you go do this. I happen to be an expert, so don't go get an electric bike and get out here in the road. I need you to understand that this is simply a test. But as you can see, we're holding our own. And I put on the Strava just so we can keep up with the mileage. So we're gonna go a nice little ways. We're gonna do a decent review. And then when we get back to the shop, I wanna show you some of the features that you can output on this bike, or put on actually. You can equip this bike with saddle bags. She already has lights, so I don't think you have to worry about that. I'm going to show you the features and how she works, and I'm going to show you a few other things that come with a bike of this nature and build. So let's get to it. I want to ride up to Lady A, and then we'll stop. I'll give you an in-depth review on some of the features of this bike. Come on, let's go. Immediately, I've started off with her in turbo just because I understand how this bike works. You guys have been with me on reviews with Ego Boost and Sport, so we don't got to go through all of that. But what I am going to tell you is riding this bike requires some really nifty shifting. Excuse me, fellas. And what I mean by that is this bike has a shift feature on it, right? And the feature for it, excuse me. The feature for this bike on the electrical assist is solely based off of your shifting. So I'm gonna bring her all the way down to first. Excuse me. Oh, she can't hear me. She got heads moving. Check it out. Now I am all the way in first gear, right? Y'all see my legs all funny, all that good stuff. Now, because I'm in first gear, the electrical assist only works when you're pedaling, and it only works to a certain extent while you're pedaling. Now this bike has gotten me up to 20 miles an hour, Right now we're cruising at 9 because we're in the park and we're going at a moderate pace. So, just so you know, in order for you to get the best out of the electrical assist on this bike, you're going to have to shift this bike like you're riding it as a real motorcycle. I know that sounds different, but that's how the shifting is designed on a regular bike. All of my road riding people, Critwit helped me out with this one. G-Money helped me out with this one. All of my road cycling people shift gears as if they're riding a motorcycle. You know what I mean? And downshifting and upshifting is what we call it. Now, I downshifted, and as you guys can see, I'm not pedaling or anything, and she is floating. Now, her tires need a little air in them, but that's okay. We'll take care of that when we get back to the shop. As you can see, I am floating, literally. I haven't pedaled. As you can see, we're still moving at about 8 miles an hour, which is our pace. Oh, and now we're gonna shift up. There's two, there's three, there's four, fourth gear, you see it? There's five, there's six, there's seven. Now, as you can see, our speed has increased tremendously, right? Now, let me add some pedal to it. Now, that's me pedaling, right? We're almost at 20-something miles a freaking hour. Do you see that? You see that? Now, that's me pedaling. You still have to put the effort into the bike. Now, watch what happens. Listen closely. That's me pedaling. Look how fast we're going. So the more effort you put into the bike, the more effort the electrical assist will give you. Here, let's get a little higher. Check that out. Isn't that crazy? So, I just want you to be clear. This bike does not zoom by itself. It goes through whatever effort you put towards it. You know what I mean? So the more effort you put into it, the more effort it'll give you as an assisted bike or e-bike. You know, what we call electrical assist bike. All right, so we have made it back to the shop, good humans, and you're wanting to know what my thoughts and recommendations are on that particular model bike, and I'm going to tell you right now. I would say, for someone who lives in the city, that is a great way to do your deliveries, make your money, and get around. Like I told you, the more work you put into the bike, the more it helps you. And as you guys see, we got up to almost 25 to 30 miles an hour on that bike, and I never experienced that kind of speed before. Now, as someone who is a weekend warrior, if you need something that'll help you hit the trails real nice and comfortable without overdoing it, those of you who like to get out and explore and do like the overnight backpacking type of travel deal, that is perfect. You have room for saddlebags, you have room for front bags. If you remember the front bike bag we did, that was the bike we took out. You have so many options with this bike, it's ridiculous. And then those of you guys who are just looking for a solid e-bike, there it is. You guys seen it. Y'all seen me out in traffic with it. We rode with it. It does anything you ask it to do. It will do. So, my honest opinion, is it worth the money for the buy? Yes. Where do you come get it from? Naturally, I'm gonna tell you Chain Reaction. And as usual, this video is sponsored by Chain Reaction. Come on out, link in the description, and tell them the mountain biker sent you. So, those are my final thoughts on that machine right there, and I absolutely love it. Those of you who have been asking me to take it out, and those of you who want to know what the bike was about, what it could do, its capabilities, hope that could be some influence towards your decision in the e-bike. Okay, good humans, this is the segment where we do Q&A. Let's go. So I'm gonna pick the top three questions in this segment, and these are questions that are commonly asked when we're in the shop. And the first one I actually got was, let me pull it up. Let me see. Hey, Al Too Smooth, why do you go by the name Al Too Smooth? What is your real name? Is it a play off of Alan Alexander, or is it just Al Too? Okay. Not that I was intending on using that one. My real name is Alexander. Alexander Too Smooth. Al Too Smooth is what I kind of picked up from back in the day when I used to look like some business tycoon who was going to work at a Fortune 500 company. You know, like that guy. Yeah, him. That guy. So Al Too Smooth became a nickname that I picked up, and then I ended up, you know, being a mountain biker, and some of my friends was like, why don't you just put Al Too Smooth mountain biker? And I was like, no. But then I said, the mountain biker might be pretty cool, and then that's where it came from. Al Too Smooth the mountain biker. And it's been that for a little while, so I figured that would be pretty cool. It's unique, nobody can duplicate it, and it takes patience to come up with these things. Next question. Hey Alex, my name is Didi, and I used to go to school with you, and I had a question. Well, Didi, I think I know who you are, and I'm gonna read your question. It says, what bike do you recommend for someone who is beginning and wanting to go outside on the greenways and the trails? That's really, really easy. An entry-level hardtail, such as a Flightline 2 or a Double Peak. It's a hardtail bike. It's really not that expensive. And let me tell you something, for the money and the price point for your beginning, you're gonna enjoy it. You can take this bike anywhere, and I mean anywhere. I've done a few reviews on it before, and here, I'll show it to you right here. The Double Peak and the Flightline are some beautiful machines, and I really think you'll have a good time with it. Come on down and Chain Reaction, and I'll show you one personally. And I honestly think that is a great entry level bike. So definitely my recommendations for someone who's starting, and that's if you're interested in a mountain bike, that is. Now, if you're interested in a road bike, not my thing, but there are some experts here who could get you set up on a road bike too. This next question actually comes from a friend of mine. His name is Edward. I know who this guy is too. It says, hey Al Smooth, my question to you is, how did you get into cycling and what made you become a mountain biker? What's the difference between riding a mountain bike and riding a road bike? Don't you want to go faster? Okay, so Ed, appreciate you sending me the question. Definitely an interesting one. I don't want to go any faster. I'm not a road guy. Road bike guys are generally in it to be aerodynamic, fast, and they have endurance like no other. 10 miles is usually a warm-up for those guys. I'm not one of those. Now, my brother Critwit and my brother the overnight cyclist, aka Garnett and Garland. I know, right? Garland, right? They are some really, really healthy endurance athletes when it comes down to riding. Critwit is actually a crit racer. And these guys do this every day. Unlike myself, me being on a mountain bike, I don't have the ability to go and do long distances like that. Well, I mean, I take that back. I do long distances on my bike, but not at the pace, speed, and the agility that these guys have. So there are two different forms of discipline, road cycling and mountain biking. I'm more of a greenway trail and dirt diving, all that great stuff. I like being amongst nature versus me being out in the road. The road is a different challenge entirely. I can't really tell you about it, but I hear some really fun things. So if you look up, I'll give you a link in the description, a few people who happen to be some expert road cyclists. The vegan cyclist, he's one of them. Josh is the daily mountain bike rider. He's one of my mountain bike friends on YouTube. And Critwit, aka Critwit Cycling Vlogs, he's also a road cyclist. And of course, we cannot forget one of my mainstream partners, the overnight cyclist, aka Garland. He's also an endurance rider. These guys are experts in their craft. I'll leave a few links into their channels that you could check them out, and trust me, you're not gonna want to miss their content as well. These guys are great creators. So I hope that answers that question.
It's more like a spaceship.
So good, humans. Chain Reaction Tuesdays. What did you think about this segment? Did you guys like the bike? And most importantly, what did you get from it? Is it something that you guys would ride? Would it be something you'd consider? In my humblest opinion, those of you guys who are out there with disabilities, my fellow kidney warriors, those of you who are missing limbs, paraplegic people, that is an interesting bike to have. And I believe that anybody with a disability would benefit from having an electric bike like that. It has multiple uses, multiple configurations that you guys can use. And I really can't stop talking and saying positive things about it. I liked it. I had a good time on it. So on that note, that is going to be it for Chain Reaction Tuesdays, you guys. Anybody, everybody, all of you, if you guys have a question, send me an email and let me know what you guys think. Leave it in the comments. I have it in the description. Come visit Chain Reaction. As always, you can come check out these bikes. They are always on display and are looking to be sold. And who knows? Leave me an email. I might be able to even give you a personal tour. So on that note, I am checking all out here. That's it for me. I enjoyed filming Chain Reaction Tuesdays. As always, thanks for riding with me. And like I always tell you, good humans, say it with me. Disability is not an ability, right? All you gotta do is try. I think we tried, we kicked the butt, and dominated today. So on that note, it is time to go get a Red Bull, go home, and do it all over again tomorrow. Same place, same station, same bike shop. Chain Reaction is the place. Al Too Smooth is the mountain biker. And you, I'll see you next Tuesday for Chain Reaction Tuesdays. Later, good humans.